Good evening. Did you hear me that time? I said good evening. Welcome to the Challenger radio station. I'm Challenger. You knew that, didn't you? Hey, I just wanted to let you hear a friend of mine. Yeah? Hear a friend of mine as I tell him about something I'm about to purchase. If I can get a hold of him. Hello, bro. Hey, bro. Well, he doesn't seem to be on the radio this fine evening. How about a pro? Well, I was going to tell him about what I was going to buy. I decided to go ahead and tell him what kind of radio I was going to buy, but perhaps he don't want to know. All right, then. Hey, Pro. Here's the radio cat. He said something derogatory to that effect. Come here. Oh, you can never tell what you're saying, you dumb son of a bitch. Now, how can you say such a thing?
Yeah, when your mom is sitting there next to you.
I mean, didn't your mama teach you anything other than how to spew derogatory remarks out of that pie hole?
Yeah, she told me what that was about.
I didn't call you a thing. I didn't say a damn thing to you that was derogatory in the slightest bit, you silly ass goddamn shithead.
Yeah, he's got to have it, man. He's all pissed off because all the little boys, though, you know, he got his truck scratched while he's out there driving that truck, and the old boys out there in the trailer park there.
Yeah, but he can say Dodge, something you probably bought. I don't give a damn if it does have a Caterpillar in it. It's still a Dodge, damn it. Rapping that old lady, just rapping it. Just bam, bam, bam. Where's the other one? Let's go over here. Where's the other one?
She's like, all right. You know, time to come on by. Come on by, boys. Anyway, there'll be all kinds of bicycles lined up out here.
Trying to find that other cat. Where are you? Come here. Look at this one. Come here. Here's my other radio cat. This is Radio Patchy. The Radio Patch. Hmm? Have you been getting into things? She's very pretty. She's been with me a long time. Yes, you're so pretty. You're so pretty. She's very pretty. These are some of the radio cats. Hey, isn't that right? Hey. Oh, she wants to get away. Excuse me while I take leave with my scissors. Be right back. Hey, Pro.
Shut up. Hush up,
Bogart. No, I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. I tell you, I'm just not gonna do it. Hey, Pro. You may recall I talked to you earlier in life about SWR meters and how to use them. Do you remember that? I can barely remember. I just have a few that I wanted to show you. I probably showed you these few ones that I have. The big one here. This was nice because you can hook up three radios to it all at once. Your CB, your 2 meter, and your 70 centimeter. Or 70 centimeter. It's what it is. 2 meters, 70 centimeters, 33 centimeter, 19 centimeter, on and on into the microwave bands. Well, this one measures all that. But here's one that's really old. A Siltronix. Unfortunately, and they're built like a tank. I got this one when I was about 10 years old. Can you see it? Get out of the light, dumbass. Pardon my language. This does all kinds of things, but it don't do anything right now. Nice SWR meter from way back when. Siltronix FS9DX. And then we go to the little scale. What's this, a Vanco? Yeah. Strictly SWR meter. I like this one because it's so amazingly small. Amazingly small SWR meter. Not a watt meter, just an SWR meter. Really easy to use. Nice little meter for on the go. Standard connections, SO239. You know, it's plastic, but what do you expect? It only cost a couple of pennies. I don't know what it cost. It was given to me by my father-in-law, who enjoyed it immensely. And now I enjoy it. I rarely use it, but I use it in the car sometimes. It's very epically accurate. And then we go from the phenomenally, from the ridiculously small to something completely different. I just acquired this one. Look at this bad baby. The PM15 Siltronix. I just acquired this one, and unfortunately, I like the other one. It does not function. But I'm going to put it in the shop. This one right here This one right here is worth putting in the shop. Fortunately, we have a tremendous world-class radio shop here in St. Louis. I'm going to be able to do that with no problem at all. Have this repaired. It doesn't register right now, but look at it, though. It's huge. Look at it. Can you see it? Give you a couple of angles. Standard SO239s. You get your, this is unheard of, a 5-watt setting. 5 watts. 5, 50, 500, and 1500. And forward and reverse. What a beautiful meter. Is that beautiful? I love that meter. Love me a beautiful meter like that. And you'll see it in operation eventually when I get it fixed. That's a beautiful meter. The Siltronics PM15. Yes, indeed. And you'll recall my favorite meter, not the Epic Dosi TR1000, all Dosis. I don't like them. I know a lot of people do like them, and I'm going to get a lot of hate mail for this. You know, I've said it before, I'll say it again, I don't like them. They swing too much. They give you an inaccurate reading, in my opinion. Of course, my opinion is like a rock. It lays around and does nothing and doesn't amount for nothing. Well, see, it swings even when it's not connected. Whee! You know what I'm saying? They're built kind of rugged, not really. And you can hook it up in the truck. After all, that's why it's a TR, the trucker. 10-4, 18-wheeler, keep-on-trucking type meter. It's a good meter, but this meter particularly, when it hits the peg over here, when it swings all the way over, it sticks. And you have to give it a little... like that, you know what I'm saying? But I don't like Dosis. Sorry if you like them. I appreciate you. But I don't like them. Good looking meter, though. Ooh. And the Venerable. The Venerable W4 watt meter by Drake. This is not an SWR meter. Can you see it? 202,000 watts forward and reflected. That's all it does. It's a watt meter. Forward and reflected. Unbelievable quality from Drake. I have the matching Drake twins as well, but this one's nice because you can remove the sensor and remote it somewhere and have the meter right where you're operating in your operating position. Beautiful quality. Unbelievable. And it moves a little bit too. But it's damped. The other one, the Dosi, is not damped whatsoever. This is damped, as you can see. Oh my. Such a beautiful meter, isn't it? It's not a bird, mind you. It's not a bird. But what is? This one has been referenced to a Berg 43 watt meter, and it comes up right on the money. So I'm fairly confident that when it says 100 watts on this meter, it's 100 watts. On this meter, of course. And one of the last ones, of course, the Palomar PW5000. Can you see it? The Palomar. This one will go to 5,000 watts and reads all SWR, modulation, and watt meter. SWR modulation and watt meter in various segments, various wattages, all kinds of stuff. And this works, but it requires 12 volts. You plug in 12 volt right there. Standard SO239. You get your ground in case you want to ground. Most of the time I don't ground for some reason. My equipment doesn't like to be grounded. Well, nevertheless, that's what this is, a Palomar PW5000. You can't find these no more. And I did some immaculate trading many, many, many moons ago to acquire this particular piece of equipment. 5,000 watts, that's kind of unheard of, except for in the bird ranges, you know, with the 5,000 watt slug.
Pro.
It says for both of them, realistic Navajo. This is a Cobra 2000 GTL, 31 years old.
Now, you're talking to somebody else now, see? If he had ears, he could hear. Yeah, he was replying to the other gentleman. Oh, okay, you're right. I need better ears. I'm back right.
Yeah, I said we're throwing some smoke in. I talked to you last night.
Yeah, the 240 is my get off right here, right next to the Metro Lake. The 240, you got the Challenger on the radio this fine morning. Good morning to you.